New developments today in the tragedy on I-95, where a 10-year-old girl was found dead in a truck and her twin brother was found doused in chemicals. Good afternoon. I'm Paul Agron. In just a few hours from now, authorities in Miami are set to talk about this weekend's arrest of their adoptive mother, Carmen Barahona. Angela Rozier joins us live this noon hour using our exclusive next-gen technology that allows us to go live anywhere, anytime. Angela?
Paul, very busy day in the Barahona case. Earlier this morning, a Miami-Dade family court judge ruled that DCF can release additional documents of alleged abuse in this case. Now, those documents also include the paperwork that was filled out by the caseworker, Andrea Fleury, who was assigned to that most recent abuse case when a caller contacted the DCF abuse hotline to report that the twins were being tied up and left in the bathroom inside their Southwest Miami-Dade home. Also today, here at the Miami-Dade Police Department, officials here to release additional information about the arrest of the twins' adopted mother, Carmen Barahona, for the murder of her 10-year-old daughter. As you know, she was arrested over the weekend. Now, we asked officials if the father, the adopted father, George Barahona, would also be charged. We're told that the arrest warrants issued by the judge are sealed, and they will not be unsealed until later today. Now, also later today, that five-member investigative panel assigned by DCF to figure out what happened in this Barahona case, they will meet for the fourth time later this afternoon at 2 o'clock in Miami. Paul, lots of unanswered questions in this case, questions and we want to try and get answers to at this 3 o'clock news conference here at the Miami-Dade Police Department. We want to know exactly what happened to that little girl, who is responsible for her death, and exactly where did it all happen. Again, we will continue to follow this case both on air and online, starting first at 4. Reporting live here in Miami-Dade, Angela Rozier, WPBF 25 News. And we